So, sir, like good morning, everyone. Today also we will continue the same session, creating an Oracle database. Okay, we will show how to create an Oracle database once again, so that you people will be familiar and you know you people will be permanently perfect in creating databases. For people who have already created databases, it's a good job. And for people who did not create databases, you know they are already doing it. People who did not install the software, please complete software installations and start working on the database creations. Okay, so as I said, practice plays a very major role here. Okay, so when you create your first database, it might take 2 hours or 3 hours, something like that, because you people are creating your database for the first time in your life. So when you have to create the database second time, the time should be reduced. Third time, the time should be reduced. When you create 4, 5, 6 databases in your life, for the 6th database, you have to complete database creation in 5 minutes. In fact, I can show you database creation. I can create a database now in 5 minutes, and I can show you how to create a database in 5 minutes. Okay. It all happens only with practice. So please do practice. Okay. So let me start one more database creation. I'll create one more database today so that it will be a help for you people. Okay. So we'll be going in the same pace. Will not rush, will not run in a very speed pace or something like that. We'll go very smooth, we'll go very not very slow, I can say, but we'll go slow in the initial phase of the course, because you people have to practice and you people have to get habituated to these databases. So in order to do that, we'll go in the same pace so that everyone has to be on the same page. Okay, so login as Oracle. Password, Oracle. Yeah. And how to create a database? The first step is make directories. Where we have to create database in prod. In prod, we have to make directories. What is the database name that I want to create? I want to create ICICI bank database. So I'll create ICICI as a directory. Mkdir ICICI, go to cd ICICI. Okay. Nothing is there. So create two subdirectories, mkdir admin, mkdir aura data. Two subdirectories inside ICICI. See whether they are created or not. Yes, they are created. Okay. Mkdir is the command to make directory. Okay. It is created. First step, directory creation is completed. Second step, go to vi/etc aura tab. Okay. vi/etc aura tab. Open this file. Go to insert mode, open this file and write ICICI:your Oracle home. Register your database in Aura tab. What is the Oracle home? View01/app/oracle/product/11.1.0/db_1:y and save it. Done. Just check whether it is saved or not. Yes, it is saved perfectly. So registering the database is completed in Aura tab. Now what we'll do, we have to set the environment .aura env ICICI. Now it will be setting the Oracle home. Automatically the environment is set. Okay. Third step is completed, setting the environment. And what is the fourth step? Fourth step is parameter file. Open a parameter file. cd $oracle home. You can directly go like this, or you can type the entire Oracle home path also. View01/app/oracle/product/11.1.0db_1. Okay, DBS. Inside DBS, Oracle home DBS, you can check pwd present working directory. What is the present working directory? Where are you? The present working directory in Oracle home DBS. You have to open a p file, vi init ICICI.aura. init ICICI.aura, enter. Okay, type the parameters. db_name = ICICI. Okay, next, compatible = 11.1.0. Okay, 11.1.0, compatible 11.1.0. Okay, next, what is next? Next is db_cache size = 150m. Okay, next, shared underscore pool underscore size is equal to 150M. What is this shared pool? What is this DB cache? What is this compatible? What is this DB name? You don't have to worry at all. There is a separate sessions I told you. In parameter P file, SP file, I'll talk about the parameters. And in when there is one session which I'll give you a document to prepare, a document to make a note of it. Please prepare a notes by writing it with a pen and paper. Okay, I'll give you one notes. Okay, in that session, I'll cover all this DB cache size, shared pool size, and everything. I'll give you a diagram of the architecture. Okay, so people don't have to worry about anything. Just blindly follow my instructions and complete the database creation. Okay, so DB underscore cache underscore size, shared pool size, log underscore buffer, log underscore buffer is equal to 20,000. Okay, next. Next, what else? Control underscore files is equal to slash prod, prod slash icici slash aura data slash control 01.ctl. Okay, that's about control files. And what's next? Undo underscore table space is equal to undo TBS, undo underscore management is equal to auto. What else are pending? Undo management, undo table space. Can anyone tell me what are pending?
Block size.
Yes, perfect. That is very important. DB underscore block underscore size is equal to 4096. Okay. There is nothing like, you know,
sysox table space.
No, that is in the DB creation script. No problem. So that there is nothing, you know, I ideally used to give this parameter here in the third line. There is nothing specific that you have to give it in the third line or fourth line, something. You can write these parameters in any order you want, any order, whatever the parameters you remember, you can write any order you want. Okay. Yeah. Next, what else are remaining? DB name,
temporary table space,
diagnostic test.
Yes, correct. Diagnostic underscore test is equal to slash prod slash icici slash admin. What else are remaining? DB name compatible, DB cache size, shared pool size, log buffer, control files, undo table space, DB block size, diagnostic test. That's it, people. That's it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
That is undo table space. You have written undo.
Yeah, undo underscore table space. Okay, fine. Yeah, got it. Thank you. So it's undo tables, undo TBS. Yeah, correct. So everyone knows now, everyone are aware, right? If we are typing any mistake here, what happens? Everyone knows that. When we click on startup, no mount, it will not start. It will not start. If we type any mistakes here, if we do any kind of mistakes here, it will not start, right? So now there is no mistakes, I believe. Let me check. Yeah, okay, fine. So this part is parameter file is completed. What's next? Next is go back to your prod ICICI location. Go back to your prod ICICI. Here, give vidb create.sql and start typing create database ICICI, okay, data file, single quotes, slash prod, slash ICICI, slash aura data, okay, system01.dbf, size 100M, okay, next, sysox, table space, data file, okay, slash prod, sysox table space, data file, slash prod, okay, slash ICICI, slash aura data, slash sysox 01.dbf, size 100 m. Next, undo tablespace. I think undo space tablespace. Undo tablespace. Undo TPS. Data file. Single quote slash prod slash ICICI slash Quora data slash undo TBS 01.dbf. Okay. Size 100 m. Next. Default 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 temporary. Temporary spelling correct? TEMPORAR, temporary table space. Temp file. Single quote slash prod slash ICICI slash Quora data slash temp 01.dbf. Single quotes close. Size 100 m. Next, default 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 tablespace users data file single quote slash prod slash ICICI slash Quora data slash users 01.dbf. Single quotes close. Size 100 m. Okay. Next, log file group space one space single quote slash prod slash prod slash ICICI slash Quora data slash redo 1a dot log. Single quotes size 50 m, comma group space two space single quote slash prod slash ICICI slash Quora data slash redo 2a dot log. Single quotes close. Size 50 m. Okay. Character set UTF-8 semicolon enter. Okay. Character set UTF-8 semicolon enter. So that's it right people?
Yes sir.
Fine. Yeah. So save the file and give chmod 777 to dbcreate.sql. Just dbcreate.sql. Now what we have to do? We have to connect to SQL plus slash as sysdba. Okay, slash as sysdba. And see, for you people, it says connected to idle instance. What does it mean? Idle is very clear. Database is not even started. It is not even doing anything. It is down. Database is down. It is not even started. Okay. It is idle. In that sense, you have to do something like start or something like that. When it is not showing idle, again, some people doing startup no mount or something like that. Just check once when you connect to SQL plus slash sysdba, what is it showing? Now I'll show you. It is connecting to idle instance, which means nothing is going on. So I will do startup no mount first, no mount. So what it will do in no mount, it will read all the parameters in DBS, Oracle Home DBS. And once it will read all the parameters, it will be no mount. See, now I have exit. And again, I'm connecting to SQL plus. See, last time when I connect, it says connected to idle instance, but this time it is connected to Oracle database, which means it is already started. Again, some people again, connecting to SQL plus and again doing startup no more. And it will say like this only. Oracle is already started and it is running. So again, why are you doing startup no more? No one is completed. Go to the next step. That's it. Simple. Okay, I think this part is clear. So database no mount is completed. First step, startup no mount is completed. What is the next step? Show parameter back. I told you there will be alert log file which will be monitoring everything in the database. So just do right click, on the top do a right click, duplicate session, open a duplicate session, go to this location cd/prod/icici, okay, /prod/icici admin diag rdbms icici trace, go to this location and open tail -f alert log, open the alert log file and keep it like this, open the alert log file, keep it like this, and now you do @dbcreate.sql, start the database creation and keep monitoring in the alert log file what's happening. Okay, so let's check in which location are we. In pwd prod icici, here only we have written the dbcreate.sql, right? So just connect to sql+/sdba @dbcreate.sql, enter. Okay, something is wrong. It says sysox tablespace data file, something is missing. So just go to that location dbcreate.sql. Sysox tablespace data file.
I think that should be files, I guess.
Sorry?
Sysox data files. Sir.
Yes, should be
no
there.
Tablespace.
Sysox?
Data files.
Sysox tablespace or data file?
Files, Trishun. There should be yes, I guess.
No. Sysox data file, that's it. Fine, no problem.
Yesterday we haven't written tablespace for sysox.
Yeah, that is what I'm asking. So there will not be any tablespace, is what I'm asking. Yeah. That is what I asked. Sysox data file. No tablespace, fine. So what we'll do, we'll connect again. Okay, @dbcreate.sql. Okay, just keep it. Enter and keep monitoring what's happening. Okay, the database should be created now. And yesterday I told you, after the database creation is completed, you have to run 3 post scripts. After the database creation is, now the database is created successfully, okay? See, the database is created successfully. Okay, after the database is creation, you have to run 3 post scripts. What are the post scripts? @rdbms/admin/, okay, first script, catalog.sql. Now, you people have to ask me question. What is this question mark? @? What is this question mark? Why you are giving question mark here? Okay, what is @? @ means to execute any script in the database. For example, dbcreate.sql, I have to execute. I'm using @dbcreate.sql. So to execute any script, we will use @. Then what is this question mark? Question mark means shortcut to Oracle Home. Shortcut to Oracle Home. Can anyone say what is the Oracle Home location? I ask you to read 100 times. What is the Oracle Home location?
/user1/app/oracle/product/11.1.0/db_1.
Okay, fine. So now that is the Oracle Home location, right? /user1/app/oracle/product. PRODUCT. /11.1.0/db_1. This is the Oracle Home. Instead of writing the entire location, I am using @? Question mark. Question mark is the shortcut of Oracle Home. Question mark means shortcut to a Oracle Home. Instead of writing everything, okay, user1/app/oracle/product/11.1.0db_1. I have written @? Just simply I have written question mark. @rdbms/admin/catalog.sql. See, if I run this, it will run. So it will be proved now. I'll be proving that. Catalog.sql. See, it is running. So what is it proved? Question mark means shortcut to Oracle mode. Now, did I use question mark? No, I did not use question mark. I have written the entire Oracle home path. I have written the entire Oracle home path, user one app, Oracle product 11.1.0 DB underscore one. I have written the entire Oracle home path. For the second script, I will not write entire Oracle home path. You can check. For the second script, in fact, yesterday also I did not use the entire Oracle home path. I have written only @ question mark. So question mark means it's a Oracle home location, user one app, Oracle product 11.1.0 DB underscore one. Then why I am not writing the entire Oracle home path? Instead of writing that, I have shortcut, right? I have a shortcut called question mark. Yes, complete. Now you see, now I am giving @ question mark. I'm not giving complete path. I'm not giving complete path. I'm using @ question mark slash, okay, RDBMS slash admin slash catproc. Second script is catproc.sql. Enter. See, it is running. Proved, right? @ question mark means Oracle home. That's it. Second script will be completed in next 10 minutes. And after that, you have to run the third script. Once the second script is completed, you have to run third script. Once the third script is completed, database creation is completed. So simple, right? People, second time when you people listen to the database creation, I want answer from everyone. Second time when you listen to this database creation, doesn't it look simple for you guys? Please, one by one.
Sir.
Yes, Trisham.
Everyone. Chandana.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What about Chandana?
Yeah, I see
one person responding. Okay, no problem. So yeah, everyone understood, right? The database creation, isn't it looking simple? The database creation is looking simple, right? So I request you people to complete the database creation, you know, today. If in case you people are having any questions, okay, you people are having any doubts regarding software installations or database creations or anything, you can ask anytime, you can ping us, we will help you. There are people to help you. Okay, there is, who already completed. There are people in the batch who already completed database creation. Okay, if you people are comfortable taking help from them, you can take help from them, or else you can take help from our mentors. There are two mentors, Naveen and Ravinder. They have already introduced themselves in the group. You people can take their number and take help if you people need. Or if you people are comfortable, you know, asking me, you people can directly ask me or ping me anytime. I'll help you. Okay. There is recordings to help you people. If you have any questions, you can go through this recordings 100 times because the recordings will be with you for the lifetime. Okay. And there is a document also for you. If you have any doubts, you can also check through the document. Documentation is very much clear. See how many sources you have to learn Oracle DB. There are some hundreds of sources I am giving you. I'm giving you a lot of sources. It's all depending on you now. It's all depends on you whether to, you know, make your hands dirty or not. Only when you make your hands dirty, meaning only when you make your hands practice, keep on practicing, then only you will get. I'm telling you. So I'm giving you a lot of sources. One, you have the recordings, you have the documents, you have the mentors, you have me, you have your colleagues or your friends who has already completed the database creations. So these many sources you have. Now it's the ball is in your court whether to complete this database creation practice or not. You have a lot of resources, so many people to help, so many sources like videos, like the recording videos, the documents and everything. So please I request everyone to please complete the database creation. And for for working people also, I request to complete the database creation. Please don't drag it till weekend. It's a very easy job. Okay. I know in future classes, there will be some sessions which will be taking more time to complete. Those sessions, you can actually drag it to the weekend for working people, but not this session. These are very simple and silly sessions. Database creation is a very, 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 very simple session, which might see now the second database creation within how much time I have completed. I have completed within 15-20 minutes. So in the same way, what you people will do is once you keep practicing, one fine day you will come to me and tell that, you know, hey, database creation, I will complete in 2 minutes. That's okay. I don't know. I know what steps have to be done to create a database. I'll simply do it. That's okay. I'll do it in 2 minutes. So that's how the confidence builds in you. That's how you have to build the confidence in you. First time it will take 1 hour. Second time it will take 30 minutes. Third time it will take 15 minutes. Fourth time it will take 10 minutes. Fifth, sixth, seventh, out of the 10th database has to be completed in 2 minutes. dbcreate.sql script, I mean to say, database created, that message should come in 2 minutes. When it will happen? Only when you practice. Okay. As I said, I'm giving you a lot of resources, right? You have some many resources out there, some 5 to 6 resources. Nobody will have this many resources at the time of practice, but you people are having resources to help in this, in the practical or practice time, right? So it doesn't mean that, you know, you have to take every time, you know, you have to take the help of recording, every time you have to take help of document, every time you have to take help of, you know, mentors or me or your colleagues or anyone. No, first check with yourself, check with your confidence, whether you're able to do or not. Everyone will be able to do it. There is nothing in the world that we cannot do it. Everything or every person can do anything. Just that we have to have some willpower, that's it. So what you need to do, you have to think in your mind, you have to freeze your mind that, okay, today I'm going to complete the database creation for sure. It might be any cost it might be. It might be 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, I don't care. I will complete the database creation, that's it. And just check your output. Once you think like that, you know, check your output. You will definitely create the database and then you will sleep happily. Just think in that way. And still you are trying, you keep trying, but still some or the other place you are getting errors. Check with the recordings. Still getting the error. Check with the document. Still getting the error. Check with your mentors. Still getting the error. Check with your colleagues. Still getting the error. Check with me. You will not get the error. See how many sources, this is a very big platform that I have created for you people. It's just that how you utilize the platform is important. Okay. Now coming to the third script, SQL Plus, you have to connect to system by manager. Who is system? System is one user, default user in database. Manager is the password. This username and password is given by Oracle only by default at the time of database creation. Once the database is created, system is the username, manager is the password. Oracle has defaultly given it. What is the third script? Last final script. /SQL/admin/popbld. Popbld. PUPBLD.SQL. Enter. Complete. Exit. Connect to SQL Plus /SSDBN. Select name, created, sysdate from $B database. Completed. See, database created on 22nd June 2021. Simple. Database creation is completed, right? You can check select status from $V instance. It should be opened. It should not be started. It should not be mounted. It should be only opened. Then only database creation is completed. $V instance. It should be open. When you say open, then only the database creation is completed. If it is saying started, it is not completed. When it says started, what happens when it says started? What is the meaning of started? It means you have did just startup nomon. @dbcreate.sql database creation script is not completed. So it is just started with the parameters. That's it. @dbcreate.sql. That step is not completed. When it says started, when it say open, then only everything is completed. So this is about database creation, guys. Thank you everyone for joining this lecture. Okay. I request you people to please complete you know, please complete this database creation today. Okay. And anyone having any doubts, you can contact me. Okay. And as I said, like, you need to complete this database creation today. And in the meantime, what I'll do, you know, the next session, once you people complete this database creation session, the next session will be on SQL basics. I'll start the SQL basics, you know, I'll start the SQL basics for you people so that, you know, you'll be familiar with SQL basics also, like DDL, DML, DCL, DRL, TCL. Okay. There are some different type of languages are there. I'll explain you tomorrow what is SQL. As I said, I'm talking to you in a language which you people are able to understand, that is English, the way that I'm communicating with you. In the same way that we have to communicate as a DBA, we have to communicate with database, that is SQL, SQL language, like select name from, this is the command we are giving, right? This is a command. So we have to talk to database in such a language that database should understand. So database will understand only which language? SQL language, that is structured query language, SQL, structured query language. Inside that, there are a lot of other sub languages like DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, DRL. So I'll explain you that tomorrow, what is that and how we use and where the data is stored, how users are created. Okay, that is very important and interesting class. Okay, that I'll complete tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow, please, join this sessions. Okay. But before that, I have to check with the timings and everything. So thank you for this particular session. Thank you for joining.